Is it more of a credit to them being familiar with each other, or did it look like they got the concepts more?
I think you could see even through the losses the growth coming, and we just had such a long way to go to start, but I thought, you saw flashes in each game of like what I say, extended minutes of good play. Maybe it was only 8 the first night and 12 the second night and 18, but we finally are pushing that out. As you're trying to get to a full game, it takes a little bit with a lot of young guys, right? We have a bunch of guys just out of college, a couple of guys from overseas, and they're learning not only NBA terminology but rules and concepts, and it just takes a little bit of time. And we found some good combinations of guys to have out on the floor.
When you see a young, inexperienced player like Chris and things kind of click for him like that, how exciting is that for you?
It's unbelievable. He's come a long way in a very short, we've only been here a week, right? I've never seen him in my life until 7 days ago, right? And the funny thing is he's young, right? And he doesn't understand some of the things we're doing, like what I just mentioned. So as a coach, sometimes you're thinking, well, he doesn't really understand what we're doing. But then he gets in the game and decides, I'm just going to play my butt off and run hard and do some things, and that's more important. But it's hard to see that as a coach sometimes. And it's not unlike sometimes as a coach you fall into stuff, right? It's not unlike us falling into the Fred DeLon combination last year. We just kind of said, let's try it and see what it looks like in preseason game number 2. And we were like, whoa. And then all of a sudden that was what we did, and that was, there's some luck involved in that from a coaching standpoint of, a couple days ago I said, I think we got to play him at the 5. Let's make him our backup 5. And, that's to me what he fits in with our team. And so we did. And he did, he did good in the first game. And he ended up getting on a run here tonight, and this matchup was great for him as well with his team, and it was awesome. He did it all, huh? How many blocks did he have? About
six.
Yeah, felt like 12. He had 6 officially. It felt like more than that. He banged an alley oop, hit a 3. He was having fun out there. It was when I took him out with a minute to go. It was a good smile. You know what I mean? It was one of those really good smiles from a player for opportunity seized.
I know the stakes are a little bit lower here, but we had talked a little bit about the need to experiment a little more and find things out. Does this kind of affirm that for you? It's like, hey, maybe you stumble into something and on the right night it clicks?
Yeah, I mean, first of all, you go into the summer league in some fashion of giving everybody a chance, right? Right. So you can't get caught up in trying to maybe win those first 2 or 3 games, because it doesn't really matter. It's kind of like Iowa high school basketball. Everybody gets in the tournament, right? So your regular season is just kind of whatever. But first, we give guys a chance. We play certain guys certain nights. And they got to do something with that chance to, once we get here where we really, we want to win now. And I have to find the guys I thought that deserve to play and the right positions. And, again, we played a little bit more 2-point guards here and there, with Jordan and Cody both back there. And I didn't really know Jordan was a point guard till a couple days ago either, right? So again, I'm still learning these guys, and it helped us. Now we're going to play the guys that can help us do the job.
Giddy and OG were 2 of the big, contributors to this win. What did you take away from their performances?
Well, I was happy. I thought OG settled into the game better. I mean, obviously everybody did because of the way the game turned. But he, again, we've given him license to try to, go and do some things, right? Go play some, off the dribble a lot more. Never be afraid to take any shot on the 3-point line. You see, I'm trying to post him a little bit, and a little bit midway through the game, I was like, okay, let's get back to moving it and playing and take what comes instead of, the some of the isolation stuff. And, we're fine with that. We're trying to grow him. It's not really how we want to play, but we got to get him the ball and get some shots up. So I thought he settled into it late, and he got a couple runouts, which he needs. Like he wants to score more points. Hey, Mike, how you doing? Thanks, man. He wants to score more points. He's still got to do, some little things. Like he needs some transition buckets. He needs some putbacks. He needs a post up. It isn't all fancy, boom, boom, boom between the legs, spin dribble, flip it up. He can have 1 or 2 of those a night too, but there's got to be a kind of a formula to where he increases his scoring average.